You know, so it could be a close plus fight, but I see Spencer getting the win.
Is Porter dirty? Would you call Porter a dirty fighter?
No, not dirty. I think just that's the way he is. He's just aggressive. He just wants to win. He wants to beat you up. But I don't think he's dirty.
Okay. What'd you do to piss off Shakur?
I just don't like him. I never liked him.
Where did this like come from? Well, from you, both of you guys, it seems.
No, mostly from him. I never liked him since the amateurs. Kid's rude. Okay. Kid's loud, obnoxious. Okay. But recently, we both fought July 13th. He fought in Jersey, I fought in LA. And I had an interview. We both actually had an interview with TalkBox, Everlast Podcast.
Okay.
So, you know, it was my turn to go up. They were asking me, about my upcoming fight, how I started boxing, who's my favorite fighter. Towards the end, they brought his name up. They're like, another kid that's fighting this week, Shakur Stevenson. What do you think of him as a fighter? And there's a chance you guys might meet up. If you guys do meet up, well, what happens? So I say, you know what? My honest opinion, I think I'll beat him. I think I'll stop him. I know his weaknesses. I know his strengths. The guy that interviewed us took that clip out, posted it on Instagram, and this guy flipped. He flipped. He got upset just because I said my opinion. So he just started talking, running his mouth on my Instagram page, tweeting stuff. I'm like, yo, like, focus on your fight. This was on a Tuesday, the week before our fight, and you're over here crying about an interview, just on my opinion. So from there, it escalated really bad because he started bringing in my family, started bringing in my sister. You know, so I just stay quiet. I'm focusing on my fight against Manuel Avila that day. That was July 15th that week. So come after my fight, they interviewed me in the ring, and I just put him on check. You know, like, anybody can get this word, anybody running their mouth, and mention his name. And now we're here.
Now it's on.
Yeah.
So this got personal.
Yeah, he made it personal. He made it real personal. Like I said, I never really talked bad about him on social media.
Okay.
I just never liked him, but I never went out there, fuck Shakur, fuck this, fuck that. You know, yeah, I'm a pro.
Right.
Like, there's kids out there looking at me.
Okay.
So I keep my personal life to myself, but after that interview, he took it to another level.
Now, I know you train hard. I know you train hard and you fired up. You get as up as you can for every fight. But for this fight, is there any added momentum, any added incentive?
It's just more motivation.
More motivation
because it's for a world title. I've been working my whole life for this since I was 10 years old. And I'm glad it's against him.
Okay.
It's a perfect opponent. I just didn't want to fight a nobody. I wanted to fight a champ or someone known.
Okay.
And obviously there's a lot of hype behind him, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop that hype October 26th, and I'm going to be the new world champion.
So you mentioned you know his strengths and weaknesses.
Yeah.
You want to share with us what you see as his strengths and weaknesses?
We've been in the ring together, so that's all I'm going to say. I showed him a thing or two. I know he wasn't going all out. He was probably going about 50%. We're both going 50%. But at the end of the day, when I checked him, I stopped and I looked at him like, yo, I just checked you, like, you know, like, I got you. You're gonna get me back. Couldn't get me back. So I know what he's about. Like I said, I know what he's about. I know what he brings to the table. And there's no doubt in my mind that October 26th, I'm gonna come out with the win.
Thanks, G.